the numbers tell a story of rapid change. Since the mid-1990s, the number of Laotians living in poverty has halved, while per capita income, though still only around $800 a year, has more than tripled. Over the past 5 years, foreign direct investment has surged from only around $500 million a year to more than $4 billion in 2009, helping the country to average more than 7% annual growth.
The government itself embraced the market mechanism, which created opportunities for people to find employment. Therefore, wage earning potential was there. The second is the economy modernized, so they had more value-added opportunities, whether it be agriculture, tourism. Third is natural resource sectors opened up, especially on hydro and mining.
Hydropower and mining have been the big draws for foreign investment. The Tun Hin Bun hydroelectric project was largely funded by the Asian Development Bank and is now owned by a consortium of Lao, Norwegian and Thai interests.
Work has begun on an expansion of this project, which will double its power capacity. And some 100 kilometers upstream from here, by far Laos's biggest hydro project, the NT2 Dam, is getting set to go on stream. As with this dam, some 95% of its power will be exported to Thailand.
Funded by the private sector and donor agencies, that hydro project will earn the country around $2 billion, money that the Lao government is required to spend on protecting the environment and reducing poverty. The nascent garment-making industry has also been attracting foreign investment, particularly from neighboring countries. The industry accounts for about a fifth of the country's export earnings and plays an important role in reducing poverty.
We employ around 28,000 young workers, mainly 86% are female workers. That is a big contribution because these people came from the rural area, especially from the northern part.
Despite the recent surge in FDI, Laos remains heavily dependent on foreign aid, which makes up close to 80% of the government's capital expenditure. Aside from helping improve infrastructure, health and education, aid donors are doing what they call capacity building, working to improve the country's ability to govern itself well and properly manage its revenues.
It becomes critical because now more foreign direct investment and economic development pressure on natural resources. Second, rapid modernization in economic structure needs skilled labor. So Laos needs to improve their human resources. Third, the challenge is how to diversify their economic structure.
The government has steadily been opening up the Lao economy.
The government has made a lot of improvement, especially in the regulation, business registration process, which is shorter than before, easier than before. Nevertheless, there are still some complexity in that one, especially for foreigners. Normally, they are looking for studies, statistics, data, and so, which is very hard to get, especially official data.
For input and ideas, the government has been looking to the private sector, as well as to the development agencies.
Laos has a good momentum to maintain this good development. And with the strong commitment from the leadership and guidance, and also full support from development partners agencies, I'm very confident so Laos can achieve much better economic development and poverty reduction process.
What they want to do is look at what lessons out there in the international development marketplace that they can embrace and how they could use those lessons, adapt them to local situation, and benefit from it.
That situation includes being landlocked, but with booming economies like Vietnam and China next door. Already, Laos attracts significant investment and does most of its trade with its neighbors. But Laos needs to greatly improve infrastructure, raise the quality of its workforce, reduce corruption, and continue to make itself more attractive to foreign investors. if, as the development agencies put it, it's to go from being landlocked to land-linked.